Hi, it's Bonnie Stachowiak here to share a bit about how Screencast-o-matic works. Screencasting, which is the core function of Screencast-o-matic, but it can actually do a lot more than that, is the recording of whatever is on our screen. Right now, you're looking at what's on my desktop image currently on my laptop. Whatever I place inside this dotted line frame will be included in the video portion of my screencast. I can also record audio either while I'm recording or after the fact. Here's me getting ready to record a PowerPoint slide. See how I can record my screen or what's showing on my webcam or both? I love how easy it is to go back and forth between showing my face on the webcam and making eye contact with the webcam, and then moving back and forth between showing the slides. It's not only PowerPoint that I can screencast though. Here's me showing how to do something in our learning management system. I can click through different steps, making it far easier to show rather than tell our faculty how to perform something in the learning management system. If you prefer not to speak extemporaneously when you're screencasting, you can always write a script in advance and read from it to create your recording. Import and export options add to the convenience of this feature in case your script already exists outside of Screencast-o-matic, or you want to take a script you recorded in Screencast-o-matic and be able to use it somewhere else. The free version of Screencast-o-matic is pretty full-featured. It does limit you to 15-minute recordings, but my recommendation is really that you don't ever, really hardly ever record anything longer than that without having some kind of interaction with the learner. You can publish directly to YouTube with the free version or save the video file on your computer and upload it into a service of your choice. The pro version removes the Screencast-o-matic logo watermark on your videos, allows for longer than 15-minute recordings, has editing tools, scripted recordings, drawing and zooming, other places to publish directly to beyond YouTube, and a screenshot tool. This has been a brief look at Screencast-o-matic. If you haven't ever used it, I suspect you'll be surprised at how quick it is to get up and running with it. If it's been a while since you've seen it, you might be like me and be delighted with how easy it is to use, but also how robust it is. If you enjoyed hearing about this tool we can use in our teaching, check out the Teaching in Higher Ed podcast on your favorite podcast app, or visit teachinginhighered.com to learn more about how to facilitate learning in higher education.